Hello everyone, this is my fourth video on computer networks. This video is brought to you by Newton's Group of Institutions. This is Arvind Egireddy from Department of CSE. In this video, we will discuss about TCP/IP in computer networks. So in the last video, we have discussed about the TCP/IP reference model. Please go through it for the better understanding. The link will be provided in the description box. Now in this video, we will discuss about the history of TCP/IP, characteristics of TCP/IP, TCP/IP layers, how TCP/IP works, applications or uses of TCP/IP, benefits of TCP/IP, challenges of TCP/IP. Here, TCP/IP in computer networks. TCP/IP stands for Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. It is set of conventions or rules and methods that are being used in interconnection devices or internet. The internet protocol suite is commonly known as TCP/IP as the foundational protocol in the suite are Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. So it chooses how this information will be traded over the web through end-to-end communication that incorporates how the information ought to be organized in bundles, addressed, sent and received at the goal. So this communication protocol can be utilized to interconnect organized devices in a private network such as intranet or extranet. Coming to the history of TCP/IP, the Defense Advanced Research Office, DARPA, the investigation department of the US Department of Defense, made this TCP/IP shown in the 1970s for the utilization in the ARPA net, a wide zone organized that zone before the web. Here, the TCP/IP was initially planned for the Unix working framework, and it is being built into all of the working frameworks that came after it. Now coming to the characteristics of TCP/IP, first one is shared data transfer. Here the TCP allows application to create channels of communication across the network. It also permits a message to be spread into a small packets before they are transmitted over the web. And after that, it collects it in the right order at the destination address. So it guarantees the solid transmission of data across the network. The second characteristic is internet protocol. The IP address tells the packets the address and the route so that they reach to the proper destination. It includes a strategy that empowers portal computers on the internet connected to arrange forward the message after checking the IP address. And the third characteristic is reliability. So the most vital feature of TCP is solid data delivery. So it arranges to supply unwavering quantity. TCP must recover information that is harmed, misplaced, copied or conveyed out of arranging by the arrange layer. And the fourth characteristic is multiplexing. So multiplexing can be achieved through using number of ports. Now coming to connections, before application forms can be sent information by utilizing TCP, the device must set up a connection. So the associations must be made between the harbor number of the sender and the collector devices. Now let us see the TCP/IP layers. So we know that the TCP/IP has four layers. The first and the topmost layer is a application layer. So an application layer is the topmost layer within the TCP/IP model. When one application layer protocol needs to communicate with another application layer, it forwards the information to the transport layer. And here the transport layer is the second layer. So it is responsible for the reliable flow control and correction of data that is being sent over the network. There are two protocol layers used in this layer. One is user datagram protocol UDP and the other one is transmission control protocol TCP. Now coming to the third layer, that is internet or network layer. So it is the third layer of the TCP IP model and which is also known as network layer. So the main responsibility of this layer is to send packets from any network and they arrive to the goal respectively of the route they take. And the fourth layer, network access layer. So it is the lowest layer of the TCP IP model. And it is a combination of the physical layer and the data link layer which is being present in the OSI reference model. Its main responsibility is to transmit information over the same network between two different devices. Now, let us see how this TCP/IP works. TCP/IP employs the client-server denomination or demonstration of communication, in which a client or a machine is given the benefit like sending a web page by an other computer that is the server within that particular network. So collectively, this TCP/IP suite of conventions is classified as stateless, which suggests that each client request is considered as a new, since it is interrelevant to that particular past request. So being stateless, which liberates up the network paths so they can be utilized continuously. And the other thing how it works is the transport layer itself is stateful. So it transmits a single message and its connections remains open until all the packets in the message have been received and reassembled at the destination. So the TCP/IP model, which differs from the seven-layer open system interconnection model, OSI model, which is being designed after it. Now, let us see some of the applications of this TCP/IP. So in our previous video, we have discussed about the TCP/IP reference model. In that, we have seen the application layer and we have seen the different protocols where we can use. You please go through that particular video. The link will be provided in the description box. Now, let us see once again few more applications where we can use these protocols in the real-time environment. The first one is SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. So here it helps to send the emails to an other email address. Next, FTP, file transfer protocol. It is used for sending large files. The third one is DHCP, dynamic host configure protocol. It assigns the IP address. Fourth one, Telnet. It is bidirectional text communication via a terminal application. Fifth one, HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Generally, we see that this is used for transferring the web pages. Next, DNS, Domain Name System. It transmits the website name to the IP address. And SNMP, Simple Network Time Protocol. It provides the time of the day to the network devices. Now, let us see some of the benefits of the TCP/IP. So, it is an industry standard demonstrate that can be viably deployed in the common sense organized problems. And the second benefit is it is interoperable, that is, it permits cross-platform communication among the heterogeneous networks. The third one is benefit is it is an open convention suite. It is not claimed by any specific established and so can be utilized by any individual or an organization. The fourth benefit is it may be versatile client-server engineering. That is, it permits systems to be included without disturbing the current services. And the fifth benefit is it allots an IP address to each computer to be organized, hence making each device to be identifiable over the range. So it allots each location a space title. It gives the title and address, which determines the administrations. Now coming to the challenges of TCP/IP. So the first one is it is not generic in nature. So it comes up short to represent any protocol stack other than the TCP/IP suite. For the case, it cannot depict the Bluetooth connections. And the second challenge is it does not clearly isolate the concepts of services, interfacing and protocols. So it is not appropriate to portray unused advances in the modern network. And the third challenge is it does not recognize between the data link and the physical layers, which has exceptionally distinctive functionalities. And the fourth challenge is the information interface layer out to concern with the transmission of outlines. So on the other hand, the physical layer out to lay down the physical characteristics of the transmission. And the fifth one is, in this model, the transport layer does not guarantee the delivery of the packets.
ప్రపంచ ప్రసిద్ధి పొందిన విద్యా నిలయ స్థాపకులు ఆచార్య నాగార్జునుడు నడయాడిన నెలలో అమరావతి రాజధాని ప్రతిష్టాత్మక విద్యా సంస్థ న్యూటన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్ మాచర్లా 2001లో స్థాపించబడి ప్రతి విద్యార్థి చదువులో ఎదగాలనే ఉన్నత లక్ష్యంతో ఇంజనీరింగ్ విద్యను గత 16 ఏళ్లుగా అంకిత భావంతో అందిస్తున్న సంస్థ. సృష్టికి ప్రతి సృష్టి చేసేది ఇంజనీర్లైతే అటువంటి అత్యుత్తమ ఇంజనీర్లను సృష్టిస్తున్న సంస్థ న్యూటన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ కాలేజ్.
That's it for today. Thank you all. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for the latest notifications.